All right, let's get started. First thing you're going to want to do is make sure that you have installed Baldur's Gate 3 and have launched it at least once. The next thing you're going to go ahead and do is open up a web browser here and head over to this website. This is a GitHub website for Baldur's Gate 3 mod loader. So if you go ahead and scroll down here, you can read the setup here, but we're going to go ahead and walk through it. We'll click on Microsoft.NET Framework right here. Go ahead and run this setup and installer if you haven't done this already before for previous projects. I'm going to go ahead and run it here. If you have done it, the only thing it's going to do is just show this message. So if you have that message, you're good to go. If not, run the installer. We'll go back to the GitHub website and we'll grab the download for the mod manager here. You'll get this zip folder. Once that's downloaded, go ahead and open it up. And we're going to go ahead and right click our desktop, create a new folder, and you can call this whatever you want to. I'm just going to call it B3 mod manager. And we'll extract the contents of this folder right here. Close this out, open this up, and there should be an application file in here. Just go ahead and double click on that to run it. And if this is your first time setting this up, you might get prompted with a download. Just click download. It's an update. But after that's done, you should get this right here. We're going to close this out. And I like to go back to the main folder here, right click and create a new folder. And we're going to call it mods. And this is where I'd like to drag and drop all the mods that I download for Baldur's Gate 3 just to keep them in one space. So the next thing we're going to go ahead and do is open up Nexus. I'll have the links down below for all of this. But we're basically just going to be looking for mods that we want to download on Nexus. And right here, I'm scrolling down to show the installation instructions. It is very important to scroll through these pages and read those, as every mod is not necessarily the same. So I'm going to show you guys a couple ways of downloading these mods here, just to give you guys a feel of what you're going to be expecting as you're changing the files in your Baldur's Gate 3. The next thing I want you guys to keep an eye out here is this requirements tab. When you select a mod, it's also important to check the requirements. You want to make sure that you download the required mods as well. Otherwise, the mod that you're looking to download won't work. So go ahead and check the requirements, the installation process. And then as soon as you're pretty sure you have what you want, you can go ahead and go into download here. We'll go into files, pick the file that you want to that fits best for you. And then just select manual download here. So right here, this is important to note because these require both of these parts. So we're going to go ahead and download both of these parts here. And they have their own installation instructions that's separate from the mod manager. So we'll be covering that as well. For this mod right here, we'll have to go into the files and just drag and drop a few files. It's a little bit more complicated than using the mod manager, but that's okay. Like I said, we're going to go ahead and show it off. For this mod right here, it's showing that you can download it and install it via the mod manager, which is great. You can also install it manually, which is fine as well too. But we'll be going with the mod manager as often as we can. As soon as those are all done downloading here, if you'll remember, we made this mods folder. Now we're just going to go ahead and kind of drag and drop these all into there. Get those copied over. We can delete them out of our downloads folder. That's fine. But now we're just going to be focusing on this mods folder right here. We're going to start at the very top. I also didn't close my web browser either. Just because I wanted to be able to go back and check the installation instructions. This is a little bit more involved than other games we've covered on this channel, but I did want to make sure that I get you guys a solid platform so you feel like you guys are doing this right here. So we'll open up the mod manager here, and we're going to just try to import the mods that we can for now. So I know that I can do this mod right here. It said so in the instructions. I also know that I can do this mod right here. Actually, I think, let me just check real fast. Yep, so I'm looking over here. It looks like that I will have to do that manually. So we'll go with the next mod and we'll open that so I can go ahead and do this here. And then we're just going to drag them over. You'll notice that some of them went down into the overrides and they're still under the disabled tab. But if you right click and open it in folder, it's in the mods folder. So that's important to know. If you drag a mod from the disabled tab over to the enabled tab and it doesn't work, just check the overrides. It should be down there. So we'll go ahead and open up these next mods that I know are going to be able to be installed here, and then we'll do the manual installation after this. Okay, so I just had to triple check the installation instructions really fast here. It is this mod right here. We'll drag and drop that, and it's under overwrites here. It looks like it didn't drag and drop over, but it is under the mods folder, so that's the important thing. So all these .pak files, they all get put in that mods folder there, and those are good to go. Let's get on to manual installation. This is where it's important to make sure that you still have these windows pulled up, as every mod is slightly different in their own way. This first one here is just telling us that we need to go ahead and drag and drop its files into this folder. So what we're going to go ahead and do is open up Steam right down here. We're going to right click, manage, and browse local files. This will take us right to the game folder exactly where we need to go. Now we need to go ahead and check the installation files. Where did it need that at? It needs it in the bin file. So let's go ahead and open up our mod here. This one, where is it? These ones right here. Yep. Part one and part two. Make sure that you check those every time. Okay, so we'll go ahead and open these up here. We'll drag them and drop them into the bin folder, just like the instructions said. Now, if this seems a little complicated for you guys, generally you wouldn't be installing this many mods at once. If you do it one at a time and just install these mods one at a time, it might be a little bit easier to start out with. So we're going to go ahead and open up this next mod, and it's got a data folder in it. And I remember seeing a data folder in here. You'll notice that these two are very much alike. When you see them, they usually need to be combined. If you open up a mod and see that it has two alike folders, and that's generally because it wants you to put the contents of that inside that folder. So you can also check the installation instructions just in case you're not totally trusting it. However, I've done modding so many times in this a million times that even if I know there was an issue, I know where the issue would be at. So make sure you take this one step at a time. If you see alike folders and you know that they need to be combined, just go ahead and combine them. We're going to go ahead and open up this next mod here, and it has a data folder. Perfect. We were just playing around with that. So let's go ahead and drag and drop that. Actually, I think that was the wrong file here. No? Yeah, that's the wrong file. So let's get rid of that so that we don't make that mistake anymore and just work with the files that we're working with. This is the one that I'm looking for. So I know that this public folder needs to be combined with this public folder. And this is all just kind of building your game files back together to the way that you want it to go based off of the mods that you're installing. So now that that's all done, we can get rid of that so that we don't have to worry about that anymore. And we should be pretty much ready to go. So I believe that's all of our files we've manually installed. We've also installed using this. We're going to go ahead and click the play button here in the mod browser. And this is pretty much ready to go. So I do want to go ahead and thank everybody so much for watching. If you guys did like this, go ahead and make sure you leave a like or comment on the video or subscribe. All of your guys' support means the most to me. This is my full-time job, so anything you guys can do to help, keep these tutorials coming. I know you guys prefer these sort of shorter things, so I will do my best to break this down for you. And I do want to thank you all so much for watching. Check out the Discord down below, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye-bye.